It's a place where football lives in its purest form. You come here to work, to do your job, to have faith that the man next to you does his, to leave it all on the field for your fans, and let the wins, the rankings, and the titles fall into place. In Happy Valley, it's an opportunity to begin again.
Legacy! Think about why you came here!
A chance to create a new story.
We got an opportunity here!
They remained resilient, rebuilt the reputation.
To write your names, man! To write the history!
Broke through.
And Penn State, their signature win!
And returned. Tonight, two teams overlooked for most of the year step into the spotlight. With everything to prove. Penn State.
You got anything in you? Give me that.
Not take a shot. It is a touchdown.
Wisconsin. The Big Ten Championship.
So much on the line, partner, for both these teams.
Right.
A Big Ten championship, a berth to the Rose Bowl, and a possible berth in the college football playoffs.
Yep.
And when you look at this Wisconsin squad, we're going to see one of the most disciplined and the most physical teams in the nation go at it.
Yeah, in this day and age of college football where we're all built for explosive offenses and a lot of points, Wisconsin is the exact opposite. They're built for control, and they do that with their featured back, Corey Clement. This guy is explosive on the outside. He's a quality receiver as well out of the backfield. He's going to get 20 to 30 touches tonight. He is the bell cow, but the calling card for this Wisconsin team is the defense, led by two sensational outside linebackers, T.J. Watt and Vince Beagle, and they're going to have their hands full. Because, partner, this Penn State offense is running on full octane here in the back half of the season.
All right, it's been a Cinderella year for the Penn State Nittany Lions. 5 years ago, this program and this university was rocked by a scandal, but tonight they have an opportunity to revive Camelot, and they're going to lean on their Sir Lancelot, Saquon Barkley.
Oh, isn't he a good back? I mean, I think he's one of the best backs in the entire country. He's got it all the versatility you would want. Great vision. He's got speed on the outside that he can take at the distance. He can catch the ball out of the backfield, and he's powerful enough to run through tackles. Everything in this offense runs through Saquon Barkley. And so if Trace McSorley, their quarterback, is going to have success, it's going to be off of play action, faking it to Barkley in the backfield, getting it down the field and forcing it down to his very tall and athletic wide receivers. And then the magician, the wizard, he's Merlin of Camelot, Trace McSorley on the outside, but it all runs through Saquon Barkley.
All right, this is a series that dates back to 1953. Wisconsin leads it 9-8, but Penn State has won four of the last five. Time now to join the third member of our team on the sideline, Shannon Spake.
That's right, Gus. Just a little update on the Wisconsin quarterback situation. Head coach Paul Chris told me during warmups that he still does not know if Alex Hornibrook is even going to play in this game. Hornibrook left the game 1 week ago with a head injury. He did pass concussion protocol this week, practiced with the team, and even warmed up here tonight. But Paul Chris told me it is not his decision right now. It's up to Hornibrook and the athletic trainer. So Bart Houston is starting this game, and Bart Houston is the only guy. If he has to come out of the game for any reason, if it's for one or two plays, Chris told me they'll get creative maybe with a wildcat situation. But if Houston has to come out of this game for an extended period of time, they will have to burn Caray Lyles' red shirt. He's the freshman.
All right, Shannon. So coming up after After a break, we'll bring out the 7th-ranked Penn State Nittany Lions and the 6th-ranked Wisconsin Badgers. Welcome back to Lucas Oil Stadium for the 2016 Big Ten Championship. Number 6 Wisconsin taking on number 7 Penn State. This season, the Nittany Lions have defied the odds, exceeded expectations, and rallied together in pursuit of a singular goal, a conference championship. Tonight, they look to complete their return to national prominence.
Improbable? That might be the best way to describe this Penn State season.
He bull rushes his way into the end zone. Game, set, and Eastern Division Championship.
Nobody expected us to be here. Except us.
He stood up! Touchdown, Penn State! Electrified Beaver Stadium!
The Nittany Lions have fought to be back amongst the elite. And tonight, we accept nothing less than that Big Ten championship. We are unrivaled, and we are.
We are.
We are.
We are.
Penn State.
Penn State.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Penn State Nittany Lions. Their 4th appearance in this championship game. Wisconsin is no stranger to this stage. After a season where the Badgers' fortitude was tested every single night, they look to bring the championship trophy back to the Badger State.
The Wisconsin Badgers, winners of the Big Ten West. When others counted them out, they persevered.
Cause we're gonna be
the determination to achieve greatness unites them. They're a relentless physical unit whose defense is fearless.
It's picked off! It's picked off!
Oh, what a big play by the defense!
Yeah, they've been here before. But this is a new year. It's now or never. A Big Ten championship and a college football playoff bid are now within reach.
Got this feeling in our souls we carry. It's about to be a
so to all those who doubted me, get ready, because tonight, it's about to be legendary. On Wisconsin.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Wisconsin Badgers. So coming up, Wisconsin, Penn State. For the Big Ten Championship, it's about to go down in Indy. Welcome back to the 2016 Big Ten Championship game. Right now, let's go to public address announcer Mike Jansen.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand as we honor America and our armed forces around the world with the playing of our national anthem. The Penn State Marching Band and the Wisconsin Marching Band proudly combine in a spirit of sportsmanship and musical friendship. And now please welcome the director of the Penn State Marching Band, Greg Drain, as he leads 600 Big Ten musicians in the playing of our national anthem.
Big Ten championship game. Coming up after this break, the coin toss. Welcome back to Indianapolis for the 2016 Big Ten championship game. Now for a special coin toss ceremony, let's go to public address announcer Mike Jansen.
Ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention to midfield for tonight's special coin toss. This past July, we were shocked and saddened by the tragic loss of Michigan State graduate Mike Sadler and Nebraska student Sam Foltz. Both of these young men left an indelible mark on their teams and institutions and positively impacted the lives of all those around them. We are honored to have Karen and David Sadler, joined by their daughter Katie, as well as Jill and Gerald Foltz, join us for tonight's game. The coin being used features images of Mike and Sam that were submitted by Michigan State and Nebraska to honor their lives. We hope that you'll join us in sharing our continued thoughts and prayers with these families and university communities across the Big Ten.
Captains, welcome. Wisconsin, you're the visiting team. Sadler or Foltz, which call do you make?
Sadler.
He calls Sadler. We'll let it land on the ground. Sadler it is. Wisconsin, you win the toss.
Like to defer to the second half.
They want to defer to the second half. Wisconsin wins the toss, defers to the second half. You want to receive. Where would you like to kick from?
We'll protect our hands, don't kick their way.
Swing around here, please. Penn State over here.
As we get ready for kickoff at the 2016 Big Ten Championship, here is the winning look, sponsored by Coca-Cola. Lucas Oil Stadium, and we are set for kickoff at the Big Ten Championship game. Sixth ranked Wisconsin, seventh ranked Penn State. Wisconsin won the toss, deferred. Penn State to receive. Paul Christ turned 51 2 weeks ago in his second year at Wisconsin, named the Big Ten Coach of the Year by his fellow coaches this week. James Franklin, 44 years old, third year at Penn State, named Big Ten Coach of the Year by the media this week.
Partner, let's crown us a champion in the best conference in our sport.
As you take a look at the Big Ten championship history, Wisconsin, their fourth appearance in six seasons. And we're underway. Miles Sanders, the deep man, and he'll get a shot, bringing it out of the end zone. Sanders gets across the 25, close to the 30-yard line, before being taken down. And a couple of things you need to know.
When Penn State has the ball, they love to take shots down the field. Their big play threat on the outside is Chris Godwin. He's got the size over his counterparts on the opposite side for Wisconsin. They're a smaller secondary that's very aggressive. Sojourn Shelton is their leader, a four-year starter, leads a very productive secondary that leads the country with 21 interceptions.
First down and 10 at the 29. Saquon Barkley in the backfield. They give it to him on first down, and he gains positive yardage as he crosses the 35 up to the 37. Dakota Dixon with the tackle here is the Big Ten's most outstanding offensive player, most outstanding running back.
And he's hobbling off the field. That's exactly what the Nittany Lion fans did not want to see. He came in with a bit of a bum ankle. He tried to play it off during the course of the week, said he could have come back in that game last week against Michigan State, but hobbling off early is Penn State's best player.
Andre Robinson replaces him, and they'll give it to him. And Robinson smashed as he gets to the line of scrimmage. Trace McSorley also decked Vince Beagle with the tackle, and these linebackers for Wisconsin are nasty.
Well, we're going to see the strategy play out right away. In this zone read game, the outside linebackers for Wisconsin are going to attack the quarterback, and Trace McSorley gets walloped by T.J. Watt.
Third down and three at the 36. McSorley operating out of the shotgun. Robinson standing with him. Here's McSorley looking in trouble. Steps up in the pocket, runs into his teammate, fires, and incomplete. Gasicki, the intended receiver. So Penn State will have to punt it away.
This is one of the stingiest defenses in the entire country. Third in the nation in scoring defense, giving up just over 13 points a game. And they show you just how aggressive and physical they can be on the opening series.
Chaz Peavy, the deep man. For Wisconsin, standing at his own 24-yard line. Blake Gilligan, freshman from Smyrna, Georgia, the punter at the 21. Peavy backpedaling. Lets it go over his head. And a beautiful punt, which will be downed inside the 20-yard line. 44 yards. So the Badgers coming on the field for the first time on offense. Bart Houston in for Alex Hornibrook. And a couple of things you want to know when Wisconsin has the ball.
Yeah, regardless of who's in at quarterback, it has to go through Corey Clement. This guy is a 1,000-yard rusher. He's the focal point of the offense. And then defensively for Penn State, their linebacker core is finally healthy. And when Jason Kabinda and Brandon Bell have been in the game, they have been one of the best defenses in the country. They're both healthy tonight.
First and 10 of the 19. Clement, the single setback. And they'll give it to him off first down with running room as he slashes his way to the 24. Evan Schwann, with the tackle. As you take a look at Bart Houston, 3-0 as a starter this year.
And a senior, he's been here before. Granted, not as a starter or a guy that saw a lot of action on the field, but he's been in this building and witnessed a championship environment. I believe that's going to serve him very well, in particular early in this game.
Second down and 5 at the 24. And they'll run it again. Clement, and he'll pick up the first down. So they've used dual quarterbacks for Wisconsin this season. What prompted Coach Chris to do so?
That competition in fall camp was won by Bart Houston mainly because of his maturity. So they went with him against LSU and in the first few games of the season, but it was the accuracy of Hornibrook and the fact that he was a little bit more athletic for an offensive line that was still trying to develop, and he could erase some of those offensive line errors. But ever since then, both have played.
First down and 10 at the 30-yard line. Clement again. And he'll pick up a couple on the play. Corey Clement has rushed for 2,857 yards and 34 touchdowns in his career. There's Hornibrook, who has suffered from concussion-like symptoms. Spoke to the media this week.
He did. They made him available day after the game on Sunday. He practiced full speed on Tuesday when we were there in Madison. He looked fine. I fully expect that he will be available at a minimum here for the Badgers tonight.
Second and 7 at the 33. Wisconsin continuing to keep the football on the ground. Penn State ready that time as Brandon Bell and Parker Cawthorn come up with the tackle.
And there's Bell. This guy has been sensational for Penn State, the senior from New Jersey. 75 tackles, even with the injuries that he has suffered. Missed a few games right in the middle of the season, including that Michigan game. It's a large reason why Michigan ran the ball so effectively.
So a third down and 5 at the 35 for the Badgers. Houston will throw it underneath, and it's caught for what looks like a first down. Fumagalli with the reception, the junior tight end.
Troy Fumagalli is a terrific tight end. That's his 39th catch on the year, and he just created enough space for Houston to find him for the completion and move the chains. That was an excellent throw for Bart Houston here to start this game. Tight window, third down, and he executed beautifully.
Fumagalli averaging 12 yards per reception. First down, Wisconsin at their own 41. Clement tries to cut it back with room. And he crosses the 45 up to the 46. Cawthron with the tackle. That's Parker, number 41.
You'll see Penn State do this quite often. They're going to bring in a whole new set of defensive linemen and try to keep them fresh up front. They rotate sometimes 8 and 9 guys in order to stay fresh for things like third down. So now the backups here for Penn State will be in, including 48, Sharif Miller, the redshirt freshman, number 48, 6'5", 255, very athletic. Top of your formation right here.
Radrick Shaw in the backfield. And they run the reverse. Quintez Cephas trying to get outside, but nothing doing. The Nittany Lions ready for the play. John Reed, Malik Golden knocking him out of play, and there is a flag.
Keeping your emotions in check is so difficult in these big environments.
After the play's over, laid it out of bounds. Defense, number 43. 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
First, here's Sharif Miller. He comes up the field. He's the one that's going to make this jet sweep have to loop backwards. See that? And now the pursuit of the defense gets there in 43. Manny Bowen, a sophomore from New Jersey, 6'1", 220 pounds, just a little tap there out of bounds, and the officials trying to rein in the emotions of these youngsters here early in this game.
So the personal foul penalty gives Wisconsin a first down after the 3-yard loss at the Penn State 42. Shaw running straight ahead, and he powers his way deeper into Penn State territory. A gain of 5.
Well, doesn't it just seem that Wisconsin, they always have a feature back, an older guy, and then they always have the next guy in line, the redshirt freshman, Bradrick Shaw. This is a terrific back. He's 6'1", 211 pounds. He's run for close to 400 yards on the season, about 5.5 per carry, and he's going to be a good one here for the Badgers.
Second down and 5 for the 37. Shaw again, this time running left with plenty of running room. The young man from Birmingham, Alabama, gains 12 yards. Brandon Bell had to hang on.
This offensive line is doing a great job here early in this game, winning the line of scrimmage. You're going to get a double team right here from the left tackle, Ramchek, and John Dyson, the left guard. Excellent movement, and that allows that big hole for Shaw to get vertical and get some extra yards and make a first down.
10th play of the drive that started at the Wisconsin 19. This is their opening series of the game. First down to the Penn State 25. Clement back in the game. They'll give it to him. And he'll stutter step his way through the hole and finally be dragged down at the 20. Torrance Brown with the stop.
This is vintage Wisconsin. This is a team that likes to control the clock. They love to control the tempo with that big offensive line up front. They go 314, 333, 325, 321. They are huge up front, and James Franklin can only sit and watch as they're winning the line of scrimmage.
Second down and 5 of the 20. PV in motion. They give it to Clinton, and he's tackled for a loss. Nicely done by Curtis Cawthron.
Curtis Cawthron is such a good interior defensive lineman. He had to put on 20 pounds in order to really be effective here on the inside. So now at 285 pounds, he's not only got the quickness to make plays like you just saw, but hold up in the power game. And now this is a great opportunity for Penn State to force a kick here on the first drive for Wisconsin.
Loss of 2 on the last play. Third down and 7 at the 22. Ogunbowale in the backfield. And this will go against the Badgers.
False start. Offense, number 79. 5-yard penalty, third down.
That's David Edwards, the redshirt freshman. 6'7", 285 pounds, formerly a tight end, and he just got rocking a little bit. I think he felt like he got the signal from his guard that the snap was coming. Remember, These college players, Gus, not used to playing indoors. Crowd noise, even though it's split about 60-40 here for Penn State, crowd noise is an issue.
Third down and 12 at the 27. Ogunbowale in the backfield with Houston. Houston to throw it. Steps up over the middle. Caught! Peavy inside the five. What a throw by Bart Houston.
I mean, you got to make some big-time throws sometimes as a quarterback, and this is exactly that for Houston. Watch this. You're going to get the safety moving off the hash to the left side. As soon as he sees that, he freezes him with his eyes, drops it over the linebacker, and just a perfectly thrown ball to Jazz Peavy to set up first and goal. Bart Houston looks relaxed, calm, and on target here early.
First down and goal to the 3-yard line. Clement, the deep man, they give it to him straight ahead, and he will not get in. Stopped there by Marcus Allen, Manny Bowen as well. Second down, goal at the one. 14th play of the drive. Opening drive for the Badgers. Second down and goal. Inside handoff, this time Ramish. Does he get in? Yes. Austin Ramish, the junior from Lando Lakes, Wisconsin, gives the Badgers a 6-0 lead.
On the entire drive, both completed on third downs to move the chains, and the rest was left to that big offensive line.
Andrew Endicott in to attempt the extra point, and it's good. 14 play, 81-yard drive. Wisconsin eats up 8 minutes, and the Badgers lead it 7-0. The Dr. Pepper tuition giveaway is coming up at halftime. Stay tuned to see who will take home $100,000 in tuition from Dr. Pepper. 8-minute drive for Wisconsin on their opening series. I think that's the perfect example of Big Ten football.
I'll tell you what.
Two pass plays.
I mean, 14 plays, 12 rushes, two pass plays, both of them on third down. So it wasn't just like, hey, let's get Bart Houston some easy completions. I mean, he was thrown right into the fire, had to move the chains, and did. And then the offensive line did the rest. I mean, that was a sensational drive there for the Badgers.
E.J. Rosowski sends it away to Miles Sanders. And Sanders brings it out of the end zone once again. And he'll get up to the 16-yard line before being dragged down. So the big question is, will Saquon Barkley come back in the game? We'll find out right after this. The Big Ten Championship on Fox is sponsored by the all-new 2017 Ford Super Duty. This is the next level. Tonight's aerial coverage is provided by Goodyear Tires, as hardworking as college football's most blip-worthy athletes. Goodyear, the official sponsor for the college football playoff. And good sign for the Nittany Lions. Saquon Barkley back in the game. First down and 10 for Penn State at their own 16. Play action, McSorley steps up in the pocket, wants to run it, and slides down to the 20 for about a 4-yard gain. Let's go downstairs and check in with Shannon.
Well, Gus, you saw Saquon Barkley hobble off the field. It was not his right ankle that he injured last week. It was actually his left thigh the athletic trainers were working on. Looks like he took a pretty good shot in that first series. They added some extra padding underneath his football pants. He spent some time on the bike, but it's some discomfort he's going to play through.
All right, thank you very much, Shannon. Second and 7 of the 19. And they'll pull it in. McSorley lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage. Ryan Conley, another one of those fierce linebackers for Wisconsin, comes up with the tackle.
And this Wisconsin team doesn't even have Jack Citchy, who was leading them in tackles at the time he got hurt as a middle linebacker. But Conley filling in nicely, the sophomore from Minnesota, number 43, is doing a great job.
Third down and 7 to 19. Nick Sorley taking his time. Here comes the blitz. McSorley in trouble, throws, and incomplete. No time for Trace McSorley. So much pressure, this time Vince Beagle.
And his buddy, TJ Watt, both in there. I mean, they're just not gonna have a lot of time in the pocket. These two guys are too active and too good, too athletic. Vince Beagle and TJ Watt as a tandem, they are the most fierce outside linebacker combination in the country. The Penn State coaches knew it coming in, called them game wreckers in our meetings with them this week.
Gilligan will punt from the 5. Peavy, the deep man at the 33, signals for the fair catch and has it at the 27. A 53-yard punt. So after an 8-yard scoring drive on their opening series, Corey Clement and the Badgers are back on O right after this. Fans got in on the fun at the Big Ten Fan Fest, where they stopped by the Allstate space to win prizes and entered the Mayhem photo booth. It's good to be in good hands. Gus Johnson, Joel Klatt, Shannon Spake with you. Lucas Oil Stadium, downtown Indianapolis, the 2016 Big Ten Championship game between Penn State and Wisconsin. Badgers up 7-0 with the football. First down at their own 28. Clement hopping through the hole. That offensive line, Joel, really firing off the football.
You know, Penn State's going to have to do something structurally here to adjust, because right now they only have 6 defenders in what I would call the run box, meaning the defensive line and the 2 linebackers. Wisconsin's going to be able to block all of those players, so they're going to have to commit a safety. That's Brent Pry, the defensive coordinator. He's the co-defensive coordinator, going all the way back to the Vanderbilt days with James Franklin. And then when Bob Shoup left for Tennessee, he took over full time.
Second down and 5. Clement now outside with a burst of speed. Down the sideline. Clement needs 1 block. Can he get it? Clement! Touchdown, Wisconsin. 67 yards.
You're the outside player on defense. You've got to keep your outside arm free. That doesn't happen for Grant Haley, the junior. He got sucked too far to the inside. Clement's far too quick and too fast. He beats him to the edge and gets into the end zone.
14th touchdown of the season on the ground for Corey Clement. And the Badgers all business to start this one. Wisconsin up 14-0. The Big Ten Championship on Fox is sponsored by Samsung Pay. Turn your phone into your wallet. By Coors Light, whatever your mountain, climb on. And by State Farm, here to help life go right. 14-0, Wisconsin leading Penn State here in the first quarter. Now, folks, do you ever wonder what it's like with Joel and I up here in the booth? Well, join us live on the Fox Sports Facebook page at the start of the second quarter to get a behind-the-scenes look inside the booth with Joel and myself.
And you're going to get to see our main guy, Scotty.
That's right.
Scotty dressed up.
He's got his hat to the back right now. All right, as you take a look at the drive. So far, Wisconsin, two possessions, 143 yards and two touchdowns. Penn State, two possessions, 10 yards and two punts. And they'll start from the 25. Score $1,000 in tuition now. Tweet your one-of-a-kind goal with hashtag Dr. Pepper giveaway.
Well, this is a vital drive here for Penn State offensively. Got to get some sort of rhythm on offense, and they've got to do that by establishing Saquon Barkley in the run game. This offense is predicated on him having success early. Everything is built off of that. So 26 needs to get the ball here.
And they'll give it to him running straight ahead, and he makes the first man miss with running room. Saquon Barkley now breaks it outside, gets up the sideline and out of bounds. He gains 22 yards. Derek Tindall finally knocking him out of play.
So here we go. Barkley getting the ball and showing you why he's such a great back. Look at that little jump cut, and then he shows you the speed and the burst to get to the outside and gain some yardage. As you look at our ump cam, just an excellent look at what it's like to be right in the middle of the field.
First down and 10 of the 47. And this time they hand it to Robinson, and he'll chip his way to midfield, gaining 3 yards on the play as Connor Sheehy comes up with the tackle. As you take a look at the ump cam,
that's Ed Feaster, our umpire. He's got the camera right there on the bill of his hat. It's always odd for me as a former quarterback. It's like looking in the mirror, you know. That angle from the defensive side is always so strange.
Seattle and Toronto make it to the MLS Cup for the first time ever. Jordan Morris and the Sounders face Jozy Altidore and Toronto FC to fight for their chance to make Major League Soccer history. Who will hoist the cup? Find out next Saturday at 7:30 Eastern, only on Fox, and watch it live on Fox Sports Go. Second down at 7. At midfield for Penn State, Robinson remains in the game. McSorley wants to run it. He's got a little room and is finally gobbled up. Taken down hard by Lubrin Figueroa.
The hard part for Penn State is any fake or type of deception without Barkley in the game, Wisconsin is not going to buy. Derek Tindall was the shaken up Wisconsin Badger, and so his replacement, Lubrin Figueroa, number 31, he's on the near side. Remember, Penn State loves to take shots, and here on third down, you might see Figueroa get targeted.
Third down and 6 of the 49. Barkley back in the game. McSorley steps up over the middle and caught for a first down. Deshaun Hamilton picks up 16 on third and 6.
I love this element of McSorley's game, his ability to scoot up into the pocket and buy himself another beat or two to get the ball downfield. It's exactly what he does there. Great athleticism, keeps his eyes up, moves the chains.
First down and 10 at the Wisconsin 33. McSorley fires down the field, the deep ball, and it is.
Gesicki, 6'6", 250, one of the best pass-catching tight ends in all of America. And that was just a mismatch on the 6-foot Figueroa, 31. The backup who came in, they did target him. They took advantage, put a touchdown on the board.
And one thing you know about Trace McSorley, he has a knack for the big play. As Tyler Davis adds the extra point. Penn State hitting it out of the park on that series, 14-7. Badgers up 14-7, but Penn State showing signs of life now. Don't forget, download the new Fox Sports VR mobile app to live stream tonight's game in virtual reality. It's as if you're watching from a VIP suite in the stadium. Download the app from iTunes, Google Play, or the Oculus Store. No VR glasses required.
We talked about that being such a vital drive, and boy, Penn State answered the bell, taking it right down the field.
Here's Natrell Jamerson, returning it for Wisconsin, and he'll get to the 25-yard line. Jawan Johnson with the tackle on special teams. Let's go to Los Angeles and check in with Mike Hill. All right, we'll get to Mike a little bit later. First down at the 25 for the Badgers. What does this Penn State defense have to do to get off the field?
They've got to stop them on first down. First down has been such an issue for them because Wisconsin is playing on their terms. Clement out of the game here. They're going to go with the youngster, Shaw, in the backfield.
And they hand it to Bradrick Shaw. And Shaw gets to the 27, maybe the 28. Why don't they just try to make Bart Houston beat him with his arm?
It's harder than it looks. You know, you can only run so many coverages that also are sound and run defense. And unfortunately for Penn State, Wisconsin's offensive line has just been winning the battle so far. But that is a great start on the last play. Getting Wisconsin behind the chains in a second and long situation. Now you're playing on Penn State's terms rather than Wisconsin's terms.
Ogunbowale in the backfield. Second and 8. Houston drops it off. Ogunbowale, and he'll get close to the first down as he's chopped down by Christian Campbell. And that could take us to the end of the first quarter.
Well, anytime Ogunbowale is in the game, you know that it's likely a pass. He's their third down pass specialist. Penn State got the momentum going now.
That's the end of the first quarter, 14-7, Big Ten championship game. Back after this.
Ring the bell. They get that big drive coming back and get the big play, more importantly, from Mike Gesicki in the end zone from Trace McSorley. And we've got a ball game here in Indianapolis.
But so far, this Wisconsin offensive line has won the battle, the early battle. Third down and 1 at the 34. Shaw, the deep man in the I formation. And a flag on the play. Let's see. This ball comes loose. Recovered by Penn State.
Penn State looked like they jumped. It looked like a free play. They tried to hand it to the fullback like they did for the touchdown.
And there's an injured Badger on the field.
That's
Alec Ingold.
And he was the fullback who.
Offside. Defense. 5-yard penalty. Results in a first down. Timeout. Injured player.
This is some great discipline by Wisconsin to hold their water, stay frozen while Houston uses a hard count. Gets Penn State to jump, gets the free play. And that was Alec Ingold who got the handoff, 6'2", 238 pounds, who's shaken up.
Looks like he's going to be okay. 14-7 our score. Start of the second quarter, first down and 10 now for the Badgers at the 39.
And again, here is the most important down for Penn State and Wisconsin. It's the battle on first down. It's going to set everything up for this series here within the chains. Who's successful? 4 yards is the mark.
Bradrick Shaw remains in the game at running back on first down. Here's Shaw. Gets across the line of scrimmage. And he finally is taken down by Jason Kabinda, but he'll gain 7 yards on the play.
That's exactly what I'm talking about here.
Wisconsin winning on first down. Great patience from Shaw. He finds the hole and he allows his blocks to be set up. And there he gets physical, gets a couple of hands on the ball, and falls forward and sets up this shorter yardage opportunity here for the Badgers.
Shaw, a long jump, triple jump, state champ in Birmingham. Second and three at the 46. And this time he's met in the backfield and will go down for a loss. Malik Golden, number six, first man to him.
Well, here's the changeup for Penn State. They're going to walk up on the edge. Here they're going to walk up on the edge, and then they're going to try to bring it on the outside. There's number six, Malik Golden, the senior. He's a safety. They walk him up to stop the run, and they get a big play because of it. He's their leader, their captain, 62 tackles from his safety position.
Nittany Lions with a chance to get off the field right here. Looks like Houston may have to throw it after the two-yard loss. Third down and five at the 44. Houston checks it down. Ogunbowale spinning, stays on his feet and picks up the first down. Nicely done as Manny Bowen finally stops him.
Well, they just found the mismatch here. Jason Kabinda is going to have him man-to-man, and he doesn't get outside quick enough. See, Ogunbowale, he took off almost before the snap, got out there, and then it's just a one-on-one battle. The spin away, and he converts on third down, and Wisconsin has been doing a great job on third down of converting, whether it's Houston down the middle of the field, getting big completions, or Ogunbowale there getting loose.
Wisconsin 3 of 3 on third down conversions, first down. Clement back in, out of the offset eye. Play fake, deep drop, Houston. Here is the screen and it's incomplete. Austin Ramish took his eyes off the football.
Boy, they had a big play out in front of them there. I think it was because they threw that to the fullback, Ramish. Defenses nowadays, they just don't pay attention to the fullback. In particular, when you give a little bit of a play fake or fake it to the running back, and Houston knew he might have put just a little bit too much of it. As a quarterback, you got to know that you're throwing it to a big guy, right? Might not have the hands of a tailback. Throw a little touch on that ball, it's probably a completion.
That was the first incomplete pass for Houston, second and 10. And they'll run it this time, Ogunbowale. And he'll pick up a couple. Garrett Sickles making the stop, big number 90, the senior from Red Bank, New Jersey.
Yeah, Sickles has done a great job this year. 12 and a half tackles for loss. And set him up for this opportunity here. This is a great chance for Penn State to get off the field.
Third down and 8 at the 45. Badgers need to go to the 37 for first down. Houston in the shotgun. Here's Houston under pressure, delivers, and incomplete. Intended for Jazz Peavy, or make that rushing. And Penn State finally holds.
Christian Campbell is number one. You've got 29 John Reed, both corners in the game. They're over there playing straight man-to-man coverage. Bart Houston just didn't give his wide receiver enough of an opportunity at that ball for a conversion. Good stop there from Penn State, their defense.
So Anthony Lottie will punt it away from the 41. Greg Garrity is the deep man for Penn State at the 10-yard line. End over end kick. And fair caught at the 12. So coming up, Saquon Barkley, best running back in the nation, maybe. He's back on the field right after this. 14-7, Wisconsin on top of Penn State here in the second quarter. Score $1,000 in tuition now. Tweet your one-of-a-kind goal with hashtag Dr. Pepper Giveaway. His brother's pretty good, I heard.
Yeah, he's okay.
He's okay. It's all right. Not as good as his little brother. But.
Well, I don't know about that. I don't want to cause no sibling rivalry here.
First down and 10 at the 12. Saquon Barkley in the game. Play fake. McSorley over the middle. And it's caught. Gesicki. And he'll get about 7.5, maybe 8 on the play. Is Saquon Barkley a decoy now? Do you think he's hurt?
No, I don't think he's a decoy. We saw him rip off that great long run over the right side when they needed to get going to essentially start that drive where they ended up scoring. But now everything works off of him. So as now he had some success, it opens up the play action game.
Second down and 2. Here's a shovel pass to Barkley. And he gets close to that first down. It'll be close. Sangapolu with the tackle in the middle.
And Wisconsin's defense is a little thin on the defensive line. Connor Sheehy broke his arm, unable to go in this game. So Sangapolu, number 65, is going to be taking more of the bulk of the snaps in there. Big guy, 340 pounds.
We'll bring out the chains and measure. And it looks like Penn State has the first down.
What Penn State is trying to do here in these last couple of series is throw off the timing of Wisconsin's rush. Because remember, those first two series, man, they were just coming after Trace McSorley, whether he was faking the ball or giving it. You saw those big scratches, almost those big marks on his right arm. They were coming after him, and now they're starting to do other things to try to get that rush off of the back of number 9.
First down at the 22 for the Nittany Lions. Barkley running straight ahead, and he is gobbled up. Great pressure as Ryan Conley and TJ Watt combine on the tackle. Beagle, Conley, Edwards, Watt. And there are those marks on McSorley's arms already.
I mean, this Wisconsin defense, they have been ready for that old school traditional zone read game when the quarterback is reading the defensive end or the outside linebacker and giving it or taking it with the running back. And Wisconsin has been ready for it.
Second and 11 after the 1 yard loss. Here's McSorley to the sideline. Beautiful throw and catch. Saeed Blacknell. I tell you what, these defensive backs for Wisconsin are very good, but they're small.
Yeah.
And if this offensive line can give McSorley some time, his receivers are big, fast, athletic guys.
That's what is so important for that rush, those outside linebackers for Wisconsin, because this undersized secondary is going to have problems against those athletic, tall wide receivers. If McSorley gets the time that you were speaking of, they love to take shots. They spread out here. I wouldn't.
Third down and 1. Oh, bad snap. McSorley hustling. Can he hold on? Loose. Picked up. Wisconsin. Conley. Touchdown, Badgers.
Snap just went right over his head. Way too high, a little bit off to the right, and he wasn't able to get that bounce. Just hopped back and under him, and Conley was right there. Look at the effort here. They get to McSorley. Conley's right there, gets the fortunate bounce, and then gets it into the end zone. What a play for Wisconsin.
That's what that Wisconsin pressure will do to you, partner. It'll make you speed up a little bit.
Brian Gaia, a captain, 6'3", 295. He's the center. Great leader. He's a confident guy. Just got a little bit in a hurry there. Snapped it over his quarterback's head.
9:42 to play in the second quarter. Andrew Indica trying to make this a 21-7 game. And he does. The defense not only turning it over, but scoring as well. James Franklin and the Nittany Lions have work to do. 21-7 Badgers. The Big Ten Championship on Fox is sponsored by Progressive, handing off big savings to you.
Tonight's aerial coverage is provided by Goodyear Tires, as hardworking as college football's most blimp-worthy athletes. Goodyear, the official sponsor for the college football playoff. Who are your four teams that you think should be in the college football playoff, partner?
I got to see this game play out. I think this game means a lot more than people are giving it credit for in this playoff discussion.
Wisconsin sends it away. And the Nittany Lions, Miles Sanders brings it out of the end zone, gets to the 20. And finally knocked out of play at around the 23. Now let's try to check in with Mike Hill again in L.A. Michael, what do you got?
We got you. Penn State, Wisconsin fans interested in this one. ACC title game, Clemson and Virginia Tech. Not good news for the Big Ten so far. Deshaun Watson, the Jordan Leggett, Watson's third TD of the game, maybe padding his Heisman numbers. We got the same score you got. Clemson up 21-7 in the second. Gus, Joel, Shannon, back to you.
Clemson certainly starting to play a little bit better here at the back end of the season. They've been sleepwalking for most of it, but as they take on Virginia Tech there in the ACC championship, Washington, I think, is in after that win last night.
McSorley throwing off his back foot to the sideline. Nice throw and a beautiful catch as Chris Godwin has his first catch of the game. He scored two touchdowns last week in their win over Michigan State. Vince Beagle with the tackle. Godwin. This kid is electric.
Yeah, I tell you what, Godwin is their best target on the outside. He's a little smaller than Blacknall and Gesicki, but he plays big because he plays great in the air. He attacks the ball in the air. Second player in school history with 2,000 receiving yards through his junior season. Only Allen Robinson did that. That's quite positive company to be keeping.
First down and 10 of the 34. And they hand it to Robinson. And Robinson powering his way forward as he runs right into T.J. Edwards, their number one tackler.
I think that Penn State has found the formula here, the code. Wisconsin clearly completely keying on Saquon Barkley, which they should. He's the best player on the field. But these shots down the field with McSorley getting a little time is what's hurting the Badgers' defense.
Second and six at the 38. McSorley sprints out of the pocket, sets up, goes deep, and incomplete. DeAndre Tompkins, the intended receiver, that ball thrown behind him.
Sometimes you see young quarterbacks move out of the pocket on their own rather than only moving once they're forced. And when that happens, it takes the whole timing of the play away from you. Trace McSorley is great when he's improvising and outside of the structure of the offense, but he needs to allow the defense to force him that direction rather than just taking off on his own.
Third down and six at the 38. McSorley in trouble. Throws up high, caught by Hamilton, but he's short of the first down. Nice tackle by T.J. Edwards on the sideline. So what do you do if you're Penn State? Do you take a chance and go for it?
I don't think you try to go for this. I think that you punt this ball.
Well, the offense staying on the field on fourth and two. So the first gamble of the evening for James Franklin. Fourth down and two. Here comes a blitz.
They were sending everybody, even Musso from his safety spot, was way up near the line of scrimmage.
Dangerous play for Penn State. Here we go, McSorley being chased and incomplete. And the Nittany Lions turn it over on downs. Vince Beagle with pressure. Wisconsin with great field position.
Coming up on the State Farm Halftime, Clemson trying to lock in a playoff spot, taking on Virginia Tech. Highlights the top-ranked Alabama manhandling Florida for the SEC title, plus Bedlam and Norman for the Big 12 championship. All that and more at the half. But right now, back to my twin Gus and Joel.
I don't know about that, Mike. You're not that good looking. What are you talking about? You're a twin. What is he talking about? Huh? Get this kid on TV. Nah, look at this, man. All right, first down to 10 of the 42.
for Wisconsin. Nittany Lions gamble. Let's see if the Badgers can make them pay as Clement gains about a yard on the play. Manny Bowen with the tackle. James Franklin, 44 years old in his third year, signed a 10-year contract with Penn State in 2014. In his first season, the NCAA lifted Penn State's postseason ban. Second and 9 at the 41. Play fake. Houston rolls, drops it off, and he's got his man, Eric Steffes. As Steffes gains about 14 yards on the play, Marcus Allen coming up with the tackle.
The key to this is that the tight end has to sell his block all the way through the run fake. You see how Steffes goes all the way down. Now he pops out as a wide receiver, and Houston just dumps it off to him for an easy completion and an easy first down. That is good execution, good attention to the details for Wisconsin.
First down and 10 at the Penn State 27. Clement again with running room, put it on the ground. And Wisconsin holds on.
Boy, they were fortunate because there was a couple of different Nittany Lions that had a great opportunity.
For injured player.
Torrance Brown, the sophomore from Alabama, knocked it loose. Great job going after the ball. Clement upset with himself, rightfully so. Got to protect the ball, in particular when you're in the middle of traffic there, and then just the pile over the ball.
Nittany Lion down. The Big Ten Championship on Fox is sponsored by Nissan, premier partner of the Heisman Trophy. And by the Dr. Pepper Tuition Giveaway. Learn more at drpeppertuition.com. Dr. Pepper, it's a college football tradition. 21-7, Wisconsin leading Penn State. The Dr. Pepper Tuition Giveaway is coming up at halftime. Stay tuned to see who will take home $100,000 in tuition from Dr. Pepper. I loved the kid yesterday during the Washington-Colorado game when they said, asked him what he was going to do with the money. He said, I'm going to help the inner city and all of Africa.
I think he said everyone in the inner city and Africa.
And when Uncle Sam takes half, I wonder who's really going to get up.
There's not going to be much left.
First down and 10 at the 16.
Oh, my man, what a beautiful heart.
Here's the handoff. And Ogunbowale picks up the first down.
You know, this is why I didn't like that fourth down decision from Penn State. They weren't even across the 50. James Franklin gambled after a series in which his center snapped it over his quarterback's head and Wisconsin got an easy touchdown. You don't want to create another easy touchdown in a short field. That was an opportunity to just punt the ball away and let your defense try to get out there and get a stop, but putting their backs up against the wall here with a short field, and Wisconsin has taken advantage.
Ogunbowale remains in the backfield after the 9-yard pickup. Second down and 1. They give it to him again. Ogunbowale. Touchdown, Badgers. So Wisconsin takes a 27-7 lead with 5:15 to go in the first half.
Here's Xander Neville. He's going to come across and he's going to open up that hole for Ogunbowale. Xander Neville, there's the block, gets it done, and Ogunbowale easily into the end zone for another touchdown.
Endicott for the extra point. And it's good. 28-7. Wisconsin dominating here in the first half. Dare Ogunbowale scores his fourth rushing touchdown of the season. Wisconsin averaging 6.6 yards per rush. 145 yards rushing on 22 carries and 3 rushing touchdowns for the Badgers. And this one kicked out of the end zone.
How we got here, number 6 versus number 7. First, it was the fullback, Austin Ramish, after a lengthy drive, 14 plays, only 2 passes to open up the game for Wisconsin. And Clement with just a huge run. He got the outside, and boom, he was gone. 67 yards down the sideline. Penn State answered right back. They give it to their big tight end, 6'6", Mike Gesicki. Then the poor snap over McSorley's head, and Ogunbowale takes it in after a fourth down miss for the Penn State offense.
First down to the 25, and that one deflected at the line of scrimmage, incomplete. Looks like Vince Beagle got a hand on it.
This guy is all effort all the time. Vince Beagle, what a wonderful leader he is. High motor. Here he is from the outside on the ump cam, and you see him, he just stops, gets his hands up right away on the quick pass, bats it out of the air.
Second team all Big Ten, Vince Beagle, second and 10 at the 25. Barkley breaks free. Barkley, and he'll get to the 43, maybe the 44 yard line, a 19 yard gain. Dakota Dixon with the tackle.
This is what's so great about the zone read, is that if you read it well enough and you carry out your fake like McSorley did, all you have to do is get a frozen defensive end or outside linebacker for a beat. Garrett Dooley, number 5, froze. Barkley took off up the middle of the field.
First and 10 at the 43. McSorley up the sideline. And incomplete. DeAndre Tompkins, the intended receiver. Good coverage by Natrell Jamerson.
Yeah, these defensive backs, they play with as good a technique as I've seen anywhere in the country. Now, Jamerson was beat there, but he comes back and he rips down on that right arm. Got to give a lot of credit to the new secondary coach at Wisconsin, Jim Leonard. First time coaching any time in his life.
3-time Wisconsin All-America. Jim Leonard, longtime NFL player, second and 10 at the 43. Barkley running with a huge lane, and Barkley gets inside Wisconsin territory. TJ Watt with the tackle. There's Jimmy. 21 career interceptions at Wisconsin.
And he played so long in the league, and that's what he brought to these defensive backs, is technique, confidence. And all these guys, by the way, are under 6 foot, just like Jim Leonard. It's like he's coaching a bunch of clones out here in the Wisconsin secondary.
And Barkley spinning, fighting for the first down. Ryan Conley, first man to him on 3rd down and 2. Looks like he will not get it. And Penn State may be forced to go for it again. And they will. 4th down and 1.
Here comes the blitz again. Last 4th down, Wisconsin did the same thing.
Chris Godwin looks like he's one-on-one at the bottom of your screen, number 12. McSorley steps up, strip, loose. Wisconsin has it again. TJ Watt punched that ball free.
McSorley got hammered on that play. Here's Watt. He's going to come around, and he's man-to-man with Saquon Barkley. Barkley totally whiffs, tries to hold him, and then McSorley gets sandwiched between Watt and the blitzing safety, Dakota Dixon, number 14, right there. TJ Watt. 9.5 sacks coming into this game.
and Wisconsin with the second fourth down stop in the first half.
We told you that these linebackers for Wisconsin, vicious. I guess when your brother's J.J. Watt, the wrestling matches in those houses.
You better bring your lunch pail, even if you're just like wrestling in the living room right there. A sack, five hits on McSorley, eight hurries, two forced fumbles. So Wisconsin defense has been tremendous.
First down and 10 of the 43. Clement. And Garrett Sickles comes up with the stop for Penn State.
There's just too much pressure right now being put on Penn State's defense, not only by the running attack from Wisconsin in this offensive line, but also by these missed fourth down opportunities. You know, after that ball sailed over McSorley's head on the poor snap, feel like James Franklin and this coaching staff kind of lost their cool a little bit. Punting the football is not always a bad decision.
Second and seven at the 40. Play fake. Houston rolling, looking down the field, incomplete. Rob Wheelwright, the intended receiver, and that'll bring up third down and seven.
Tell you, for a guy who didn't know if he was going to start till late in the week, Bart Houston was a starter to begin the season, was benched for a redshirt freshman, then started splitting time down the stretch. This guy is playing like a confident young man. 5 of 8 for 60 yards. They need him here on a big third down.
Ogunbowale checks in at running back. He's a good receiver. Here's Houston over the middle and incomplete. Jazz Peavy, the intended target.
Brandon Bell, just terrific coverage. He's going to come in from the right side. Thought he might be able to actually get that one, but the hands of Peavy met the ball about the same time that Bell was right there. Bell led his team last week with 18 tackles. He's been all over the field tonight doing his best to try to keep his team in this ballgame.
Anthony Lottie will punt it from the 46. Greg Garrity back deep at the 10. And Garrity lets it go over his head, bounces back, and is downed at the 8-yard line. 2:25 to go here in the second quarter. Wisconsin with a big lead. Badgers on top of the Nittany Lions here in the first half. Don't forget the State Farm Halftime Show is coming up with highlights and analysis of this game and lots more.
Gus, you asked me earlier if you thought Barkley was just being used as a decoy. I'm beginning to think he is, because they have to slow down this rush from Wisconsin. Trace McSorley is getting hit far too often, and that rush is collapsing on him far too quickly to just stand back in the pocket. Even at 28-7, they have to establish the run, because that is the starter to their entire offense.
First down at their own 10-yard line. McSorley looking to the sideline. Delivers on time, and it's complete. Blacknell with a first down.
It's a good ball there, and it started with very good protection up front.
Remember, though, this Penn State team this season has been pretty good in the second half.
I mean, not just pretty good, they've been great. Second best in the FBS as far as margin, over 170 points.
Barkley. Two to go, second quarter. We'll take a quick break. Back after this. .202 to play in the second quarter. Wisconsin with a 28-7 lead.
That's Vince Beagle. As passionate a player as I've talked to in a long time.
Second down and 9 at the 23. McSorley underneath. And this ball caught by Hamilton. Nice hands as he gets dropped immediately by Derek Tindall.
And they're going to have to hurry a little bit here, as that didn't move the chains and is not going to stop the clock.
Third down, 2 of the 30. McSorley again over the middle. And another first down. Tompkins make that Hamilton with the reception. And he'll gain 18.
Good protection there. Finally, McSorley having a little time to diagnose what's going on down the field, and he's finding some space in the middle of the field, in particular with Deshaun Hamilton. That's a couple of catches for Hamilton. 4 on the night, 45 yards.
First down to the 48. McSorley to the sideline. Incomplete. Intended for Irvin Charles.
Really good looking redshirt freshman. Only 2 catches coming into the game, but a 4-star prospect. One of these guys that James Franklin has been able to get in recruiting. He's one of the best recruiters in the country. A lot of talented young players on this Penn State roster.
2nd and 10. 1:18 remaining. McSorley to throw. Delivers, and this time Charles just dropped it.
Well, that's sometimes the problem with young guys, is just the lack of consistency, and it shows up in the simplest things, just like catching the ball out of the break. Charles unable to hang on, and now this is the precarious situation. Every time Wisconsin has gotten Penn State behind the chains like this, 3rd and long, they have brought a lot of pressure and gotten to McSorley.
3rd and 10 at the 48.
Here they come again.
Here comes a blitz. McSorley steps up in the pocket, delivers underneath. Blacknell gets out of bounds, but he picks up the first down at the 40.
Got to give McSorley a lot of credit for, as often as he's been hit today, some young quarterbacks would flinch in the pocket and their eyes would go down to the rush, but he did not flinch. Eyes stayed up, found the open receiver, threw a strike, and moved the chains.
12-yard gain, 1st and 10 at the 40. Penn State with 2 timeouts remaining. McSorley again to the sideline. Caught. Blackdell sprinting. Touchdown, Nittany Lions. 40 yards.
Another big play for Penn State for a touchdown. A bad angle from the defensive back.
Saeed Blacknell with the 40-yard touchdown. Tyler Davis for the extra point. And it's good. 28-14. Wisconsin, is Saeed Blacknell, who only had 9 catches on the year coming into this game, has 4 for 74 yards and a touchdown tonight. As you take a look at the scoring drive,
and they attack number 31, Luverne Fajardo again. He's the one that gave up the touchdown earlier in the game to Gesicki. They attack him. I don't know if they were necessarily targeting him as just much as trying to get the ball to Blacknell, but Fajardo overplayed it. Blacknell alertly spun, got in the end zone.
Jamerson, the deep man, and he lets it go over his head and out of the end zone. This week, start your Sunday with Fox NFL Kickoff and America's #1 pregame show. Then, Todd Gurley and the Rams battle Tom Brady and the Patriots. And in America's Game of the Week, Odell Beckham Jr. and the Giants clash with Big Ben and the Steelers for other regional action. Coverage begins tomorrow at 11 Eastern on Fox. Big confidence builder for Penn State scoring that touchdown, would you say, if they can hold Wisconsin to no points for the last 58 seconds?
Absolutely. You have no idea how demoralizing 28-7 feels when you're in the locker room, but when it's just a 2-possession game, feels so much different at halftime.
Ogunbowale is your single setback. They run PV on the reverse, and Peavy knocked out of bounds as he crosses the 30.
That's that old jet sweep. And remember, Paul Chris, the head coach, has a long history of coaching with and is friends with Mike Riley, who's now the Nebraska head coach, but was at Oregon State for a while Chris was there with him. He was also with Mike Riley at San Diego. And that jet sweep, that's a staple of the Mike Riley style of offense, and that's where Chris got.
Second and five to the third. Bart Houston has been efficient. Hands it off, Ogunbowale, and he will get nothing.
And James Franklin alertly right away. Franklin calls his timeout.
Trace McSorley feels like he may get another shot, so he's staying warm on the Penn State sideline. Wisconsin faced with a third and four at the 31. Ogunbowale in the backfield. Houston over the middle and caught for first down. Nicely done by Kyle Penniston.
He's just going to run a little hook route. See, he finds the soft spot in the defense, and then the ball is thrown away from the defender. That's just excellent stuff from Wisconsin. Exactly how you draw it up.
First down and 10 of the 37. Ogunbowale stutter stepping, spinning, and goes down at the 42. 20 seconds to go. Clock still running.
And I think James Franklin, after that last first down conversion for Wisconsin, is going to go ahead and leave that timeout in his pocket and head in here for halftime.
28 to 14 will be the halftime score, but remember this. Penn State won three games this season after trailing by 10 or more points in the second half. Tied with Florida State and Tennessee for most in FBS. In fact, Penn State scored 64% of its points after halftime this season. Let's go to Mike Hill.
Gus Johnson, along with Joel Klatt, partnered that. Wisconsin defense is nasty.
Yes.
But one thing we do know is that Penn State's a better second half team than first half.
They are, and they're going to have to be, obviously, tonight. And one thing that they did get in the first half was the big play, but they've got to protect their quarterback a bit better in this second half in order to get the ball down the field. There was way too much pressure on Trace McSorley. This was the first snap of the game. It was just a handoff, and bam, T.J. Watt all over McSorley. They pressured him, knocked him down, hurried him nine times, forced two fumbles on 22 McSorley dropbacks. He was beat up in that first half. Give him a lot of credit for coming back, staying tough, leading them on that touchdown drive to draw within a couple of scores, but they're going to have to do a much better job blocking guys like that, Vince Beagle and T.J. Watt, in this second half as we take a look at the Verizon first half stats. The running game for Wisconsin has set the tone for the Badgers. 164 yards on the ground. Penn State has not been able to get Saquon Barkley going with only 39 yards on the ground. That time of possession favoring Wisconsin as well. Just over 17 minutes.
So we're ready to start the third quarter. Badgers, who deferred the first half, will receive as Jamerson goes back deep for Wisconsin. Joey Julius has sent it away. And Jamerson will take a knee. Let's get downstairs to Shannon.
Well, you better believe James Franklin reminded his players in that locker room that they have been a second half team. His adjustments, he told me, it all starts up front. He said, we're getting absolutely killed on that offensive line from Wisconsin. He said, I'm surprised we're only down by 14 points. Now, I did ask him if he continues to be as aggressive as he's been in fourth down in this second half, and he just looked at me, he smiled. Oh, yeah, of course.
All right, Shannon. Byron. Thank you very much. First and 10 at the 25 for Bart Houston and the Wisconsin offense. Clement. Houston rolling out of the pocket, throws on the move. Peavy with the catch. And Jazz Peavy picks up 8 yards.
Boy, Houston has been so good today, right? I mean, for a guy that we didn't really know if he was going to start or not. Remember, Alex Hornibrook, who has been their primary starter during the course of this season, Houston has shared time. Hornibrook went out with some concussion symptoms a week ago. It's been all Bart Houston so far, and this guy has been very efficient, 7 of 11 so far.
Second down and short. Clement running, picks up the first down and more. Big hole for Corey Clement, who picks up 14 as Manny Bowen and Malik Golden combine on the tackle.
Well, here you go. Big guard pulling. This is Kapoy. He's coming around, bang, and he just gets the linebacker right on the ground. When you've got great linebackers like Penn State has, Brandon Bell is one of them, number 11. That pulling guard, if he doesn't get there and get him eyed up into the ground, those are the guys that stop those type of pulling plays.
Corey Clement, 14 carries, 127 yards, and a touchdown. Play fake. Houston sets up over the middle. Big ball and caught. Fumagalli wide open over the middle for a 19-yard gain.
Boy, this offense picks up right where it left off. That first series of the game, they went 14 plays, only had to throw 2 passes, went right down the field. And now to open this second half, a great run from Clement, getting the first down, and then Houston steps right up into the pocket, and another big completion over the middle to Troy Fumagalli.
Only 2 losses on the season for the Badgers, a 7-point loss in Ann Arbor to Michigan, and an overtime loss at home against the Ohio State University. First and 10 at the 34. And they hand it to Clement again. And he fumbled. But the Badgers, right place, right time, cover it up.
How about that? How lucky Wisconsin is. The center, Michael Dieter. Honorable mention, all Big Ten a year ago, and it just fell into his lap. All he had to do was fall to the ground. And that's the second time we've seen Clement put it on the ground and Wisconsin come away with the football.
Marcus Allen with the hit on the play as Clement goes out. 2nd and 7 at the 31. Bradrick Shaw, the freshman in the game. They'll give it to Shaw. He cuts it inside and is finally tripped up at the 27-yard line. Grant Haley with a nice open field tackle.
Not just a nice open field tackle, but as you're going to see with this beautiful cutback, he saves a touchdown because that's gone. And Haley gets him to the ground and forces a 3rd down opportunity for his defense. What a huge tackle there in the open field.
3rd down and 3 at the 27. Opening drive of the second half for the Badgers. They're 4 of 6 on 3rd down conversions. Shaw remains in. Shaw. And bottled up and slammed to the ground. Terrific job by Curtis Cawthorn.
Well, Cawthorn, see, you're going to get a pull here, but then Cawthorn, he just jets inside of it. They're trying to block down from the tackle position, but as he gets upfield, there's nowhere to go from that defensive tackle position. Curtis Cawthorn with just a huge play.
So Andrew Endicott comes in to attempt a 48-yarder, his career-long 46. Wisconsin comes up empty. Let's see if that fires up the Penn State offense. We'll take the field for the first time in the second half. The Big Ten Championship on Fox is sponsored by eBay. The gift they're waiting for is waiting on eBay. By Sprint. Visit Sprint.com. Switch and save today. And by Coca-Cola, taste the feeling. Tonight's aerial coverage is provided by Goodyear Tires, as hardworking as college football's most blip-worthy athletes. Goodyear, the official sponsor for the college football playoff, and a beautiful shot of the house that Peyton Manning built, Lucas Oil Stadium, where Penn State takes over. First and 10 at the 30. McSorley to throw it. Goes deep down the field. McSorley has thrown touchdowns of 33 yards, 40 yards, and now 70 yards. But more importantly, Penn State down by 7.
Here we go. The Big Ten Championship.
Saeed catches his fifth ball, a 70-yard strike from Trace McSorley.
And these big wide receivers for Penn State are making life miserable on the small defensive backs for Wisconsin. Blacknall had 3 inches and 25 pounds on Natrell Jamerson on the last play.
Jamerson brings it out of the end zone. And Jamerson wrestled down at the 20. Score $1,000 in tuition now. Tweet your one-of-a-kind goal with hashtag Dr. Pepper giveaway. And you can feel the momentum starting to shift. Penn State fans on their feet. Concern on the faces of the Badger supporters. Let's go downstairs to Shannon.
Gus, you said it right, a shift in the energy. It is wild down here. Not only the fans, but the benches. The players are up, coaxing the fans to get into this game. Right now, the entire offense is standing on the side as they are trying to get this defense pumped up as well. This place is rocking.
First down and 10 of the 19. Shaw, the freshman, in the backfield. They give it to him. And he'll get to the 26. And as you mentioned, Corey Clement has put the ball on the ground twice. Wisconsin's been fortunate to get it back, but you may see a steady diet of Bradrick Shaw.
Bradrick Shaw has been terrific today. 4 yards a carry. He hasn't put the ball on the ground. And when you're trying to turn momentum back, right, when you've got the energy in the crowd right now on the Penn State side, you have to lean on your own identity. Wisconsin has got to start hammering away with the run game.
Second down and 3 at the 26. Shaw again. And he'll pick up the first down as he gets to the 32.
That's exactly what they do. Two plays and two big power schemes where you're blocking down from one side and pulling a guard. That's their identity. That's what they want to be at Wisconsin. A team that hands the ball off, eats up a lot of clock. They lead the country in time of possession at 35. And when you're trying to get out of a hole like this with this amount of noise, that's what you have to be.
First down at the 32. Penn State showing blitz. Here they come. Shaw. And he's chopped down at the 35. A lot of hard hitting going on Between these two teams, Tyree Chavis and Marcus Allen combining on that stop.
I really love Marcus Allen. This is a guy that is just a junior, 202 pounds. He actually lined up. He's normally a safety. He lined up as a linebacker on the last play. Big hit there. Good, fast-flowing player. Just a terrific talent.
Had a 22-tackle game against Minnesota earlier this year. Clement back in, second and six. Houston to throw it. Houston under pressure, and Houston gets it up the field to the 36. Brandon Bell all over him.
As a quarterback, you need your offensive line to keep the pocket up near the line of scrimmage. Watch it just collapse into Houston's lap. He's got nowhere to go. He finds a little bit of a space because the coverage down the field was terrific. Had to eat it. Dive back to the line of scrimmage, and now Penn State, another chance to get off the field.
Third down and six at the 36. Ogunbowale in the backfield. Remember, he's great with his hands catching the ball. Houston straight. Who's got it? And Wisconsin falls on it, but Penn State bringing pressure. Brandon Bell punched it free.
Pressure on Brandon Bell, but that was very LeVar Arrington-esque at linebacker. You right over Ogunbowale into the face of Houston, bats the ball away, and Houston barely got back. Look at him hurdle over the running back and strip it out of his hands.
Anthony Lottie will punt it from his own 10. John Reed, the deep man, at the 27. Reed comes up to field it and has it at the 37. 7:39 to play third quarter, 28-21 Wisconsin. But Big Mo is flowing through Happy Valley right now. Fantastic finishes here at the Big Ten Championship. This one turning out to be a good one. The pitch, Barkley gets up the sideline, and Saquon Barkley ridden out of bounds by Ryan Conley after a 16-yard gain.
This is the perfect equation right here. You're going to try to get outside of the outside linebacker, and all you have to do if you're Trace McSorley is get him to commit just a little bit. He does that, and then Barkley has the edge. There he turns on the jets and shows you that speed down the field. And how about the block from Chris Godwin down the field?
They throw it to the sideline, caught by Godwin up the sideline, and Godwin goes out of bounds after picking up a first down. Remember, Wisconsin led this game 28-7 with 5:15 to go in the second quarter.
That was a great job by McSorley of understanding the coverage. Sojourn Shelton blitzed from his corner position, so he flipped it out to the wide receiver. Got an easy conversion.
First down and 10 of the 33. Barkley trying to get through the hole. And slung down after a one-yard gain. Garrett Dooley with the tackle.
This is the type of pace that Penn State wants to play with, a little bit more high tempo, getting the ball on the outside, trying to mix it up with those zone reads and option plays from their quarterback.
Second down and 9 of the 32. McSorley in the corner, caught Gasicki with a 17-yard gain. And right now, these Nittany Lions have it popping.
He's just gonna run the corner route. It's an excellent route because he gets vertical for so long. The safety has to stay deep, then he falls out of it for an easy completion.
First and 10 of the 15. Barkley.
The ruling on the previous play was that the receiver was inbounds when he caught the pass. That play is under further review.
Well, I didn't think there was any question. Not only did he have 1 foot in, I think they got confused by the replay, because watch, the left foot for Gesicki is actually going to be down. He catches it. There's the left foot. They didn't actually see that. They were looking at the right foot, which is why they stopped the play. I think that the replay booth actually got fooled. But the left foot was down, and even if they're looking at this right one, Gus, that one's clearly in as well. I guess the question is did he control it through going to the ground? And yes, he certainly did in that big old right hand. Easy call for the replay booth here. This one's going to stand, and this offense is marching down the field.
Mike Gesicki came into this game with 44 catches. He has three tonight. And he had 610 yards coming into this game, both single-season records for a Penn State tight end. He's caught a pass, at least one pass, in 23 straight games, some big ones tonight.
I mean, he's seventh in the country in receiving yards by a tight end. And full disclosure here, I mean, he's more of a split tight end. He's not a great blocker yet. He's working hard on that. He's one of the hardest workers that Penn State has. But those 668 yards are most by a tight end in school
history. After review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. Complete pass. First down.
So a first down and 10 at the 15-yard line, James Franklin. Barkley in the backfield with McSorley. Barkley. And he'll go down at the 12, maybe the 11, depending on the spot. Vince Beagle with the tackle. What kind of adjustment have the Nittany Lions made on offense to move the ball so rapidly now?
I think that they're just getting better push in the interior of the offensive line, which is allowing those inside zone plays to have a little bit of success.
Second and 6 at the 11.
That's just an attitude. That's just winning up front. So those guys doing a great job, led by Brian Gaia, the center.
Here's McSorley looking over the middle. Caught. And maybe another first down as Hamilton traps the football and holds on tightly.
He ran a great route. He knew that the first down marker was right at the 5, so he put himself right at the 4-yard line, just past the sticks. And as Leo Musso comes up to lay the hit, Hamilton holds off for the first.
First down and goal at the 4. Empty backfield for McSorley. He can run. Gesicki in motion. McSorley runs it. McSorley! And he's about 6 inches short. This kid is so gritty, Joel Klatt. So tough. Resilient.
He was absolutely pounded in that first half. T.J. Watt, Beagle, and there's that arm as it goes down just short of the goal line with an excellent spot by the official on the far side.
Second down and goal at the 1. Saquon Barkley. They give it to him.
I told you that they were winning on the interior of the line, and they do so again to get it in the end zone. That's Brian Gaia, the center. Connor McGovern, the right guard. They crushed the defensive line down, and Barkley did a great job of getting the vision to find the sweet spot and dive for the goal line. Certainly looked like he got over the goal line on that view, as they're going to take another look at this. Yeah, that ball is over. That's a touchdown. What a comeback for Penn State. How about the resiliency of this team? Gus, the most important part is you have no idea when the knee actually touches, so there's nothing in these replays that the replay booth would use to actually overturn the call, and the ball is clearly
touching that goal line.
Mike Herrera, our rules analyst, is with us in Los Angeles. Mike, your thoughts?
Yeah, we've done a quick search of everything. We can't see a knee down, can't see a forearm down, and don't see anything that could make this anything other than a touchdown.
After review, the ruling on the field stands. Touchdown.
Saquon Barkley, the numbers starting to increase, 78 yards rushing. And here's Tyler Davis. And we're level. 21 unanswered points for the Nittany Lions. Penn State starting to believe. The Big Ten Championship on Fox is sponsored by Ram Trucks, America's longest-lasting pickups. By Wendy's Sriracha Bacon Fries for a limited time only. And by Allstate, proud supporters of college football. It's good to be in good hands. 28 up, 4:22 to go, third quarter. In the 2016 Big Ten Championship, so much on the line in this game. A Big Ten title, a Rose Bowl berth, and a possible invitation to the college football playoff.
Did anybody really think, with where this program had to come from to be at this point, that they were just going to fold up shop because they were down 21? I don't think so.
Let's check in with Mike Hill in L.A.
All right, fellas, keeping you updated on the ACC Championship game, Clemson and Virginia Tech. Tigers only up 7 here until Wayne Gallman gets it. Does what he does. 8 yards from number 9. Clemson up 14 in the third and threatening again inside the 5. Does Joel Shannon.
All right, thank you very much, Michael. As we take a look at the college football playoff top 7.
Penn State looking to win the toughest division in our sport, the toughest conference in our sport, and have a head-to-head win over Ohio State. Boy, that would be awful hard to keep them away from the dance, Gus, if that was on their resume.
First and 10 of the 25. They run it with Clement. And he gets plenty of yardage, close to a first down, as he's finally tackled at the 35. Marcus Allen chopped him down.
That hasn't been the problem. Corey Clement has gained a lot of yards tonight. Over 100 yards, 139 to be exact. The problem is when he breaks loose and gets into the open field, he's put the ball on the ground. That's why they haven't been able to trust him in this second half, but they're going back to him. The elder statesman, the focal point, the feature back.
Second down and 1. Clement again, hopping through the hole, picks up the first down as he gets to the Wisconsin 40.
I think it's key, and if I were Bart Houston, I would have gone over to Corey Clement at some point in the last series and said, regardless of what has happened in this game, we're going to need you to win it. He's got to put those fumbles behind him. Remember, they haven't hurt Wisconsin necessarily. Wisconsin recovered both.
First team all Big Ten by the coaches, Clement. First down. Houston to throw. Houston steps up, shovels it. Clement breaks it to the outside, stays on his feet, gets down the sideline, still on his feet, and finally tiptoes out of bounds in front of Brandon Bell after a 26-yard gain. Great improvisation by Bart Houston.
Well, as he's going to drop back here, his eyes stay downfield, and Clement gets out into the route, and right here, you just got to make a decision. He's going to try to run for it, or you're going to give it to a more athletic guy and let him gain the yards. He just pitches it forward to Clement, and he gets all the way upfield, all the way to the 35-yard line.
So Wisconsin responding. First down and 10 at the Penn State 35. Shaw back in. They give it to him. And Shaw tackled by Marcus Allen. And he'll gain 4.
Well, they need to answer. They need
need to answer in a big way. Remember, this game was 28-7 at one point. Wisconsin dominating, two fourth down stops, a defensive touchdown, run the ball at will. And yet here the Nittany Lions are tied at 28.
Second down and 7. Shaw breaks it back with Rowe, spreading the freshman down at the 10-yard line. Marcus Allen with the saving tackle, but Bradrick Shaw got him up and down for 20.
Well, they're going to create such a big lane to run here right there. Look at it. The fullback and the running back are going to just be free. Austin Ramish is looking for someone to block, and Shaw just takes off like a bullet shot out of a gun into the secondary.
12 carries, 65 yards for the freshman from Birmingham, Alabama. First and 10 at the Nittany Lion 12. Clement back in. They give it to him. And he'll gain a couple the hard way. Marcus Allen.
I told you this kid could play, man. Marcus Allen comes up and just delivers a pop from his safety position.
Wasn't there another Marcus Allen that was pretty good in football?
Yeah, I recall.
Okay,
I think he was pretty good. Played the other side, but
yeah.
This Marcus Allen is having a night tonight. 6'2", 205 from Maryland. Hard hitter. He is a downhill player even as a safety, and he's showing you that skill tonight.
Ogunbowale checks in at running back. Houston over the middle. And incomplete. He had a wide open receiver, Fumagalli. But Houston had pressure. That brings up third down and 8.
You know, when you get a blitz, when you're going to get all these players and they're going to create a void in the defense, see the linebacker runs out and it creates a void, you've got to just get it off in time because you know that pressure is going to be in your lap. Fumagalli was wide open. He's going to walk into the end zone. Houston couldn't get it to him.
Third down and 8 at the 10 for Paul Christ and his Badgers. Ogunbowale in the backfield. He's great catching the ball. Houston underneath Peavy. And I don't think he got the first down. No, he didn't. As Peavy is dragged down by Jordan Smith. And that will bring on the field goal unit for Wisconsin.
I love what Smith does because he doesn't buy that upfield route. See how he squeezes back to the middle of the field and he keeps his eyes on the quarterback. If he would have watched the wide receiver that was inside of Peavy, he would have cleared out, created a void, and Wisconsin would have scored. That was a great play by Smith.
Andrew Endicott in to attempt a 23-yarder. And it's good. The Badgers reclaim the lead. A lot of time left. 16 seconds to go, third quarter, 31-28. 31-28, Wisconsin leads Penn State with 16 seconds to go in the third quarter. And as this chess match continues between Coach Christ and Coach Franklin, in your opinion, for both teams, what's the next adjustment?
The next adjustment for Penn State on offense is I feel like they've got everything at their disposal, running the ball inside and then still the big plays down the field. Defensively for Wisconsin, they've got to get back to that aggressive attacking style from the outside with their outside linebackers like they played early in the game.
Sanders from the 5. And he's bottled up and taken down at the 20. So let's take a look at how we got here.
Well, Wisconsin had the big lead. And then it was Blacknall. This guy takes it into the end zone, and then this was the big play. Down the field, comes back to the ball, gets it into the end zone. He's got 144 yards receiving. And then they had the long drive. This is when I thought they established themselves, Gus, on the offensive line. And finally, Barkley started getting it going on the inside. He gets into the end zone, tied it up before Wisconsin kicked that field goal.
First down and 10 of the 19 for Trace McSorley. He'll throw it. Steps up. Down the field. He's got a receiver, Hamilton, and he has it at the 40.
6'1 receiver goes up with athleticism and beats a defensive back of Wisconsin.
And that takes us to the end of the third quarter. What a game.
Woo, they got some dudes or what?
Dudes. 14 big points for Penn State in the third quarter. 31-28. Wisconsin leading. But you called this kid a wizard earlier. I can see why. He's got magic in him.
He does have magic. When the play breaks down, when the ball needs to go down the field, I want Trace McSorley as my quarterback.
First down and 10 of the 43. McSorley looking, fires up the sideline. Caught again. Hamilton. The Wizard of Camelot. Trace McSorley.
The flag came out, but this is going to be defensive pass interference on Derek Tindall.
Pass interference, defense number 25. Penalties decline. Play results in the first down.
These wide receivers keep beating Wisconsin off the line of scrimmage. It's causing Wisconsin to be in a chase technique. Then all they can do is grab the wide receivers. They're being able to adjust to the ball, come back to that ball, and just making life difficult on Wisconsin.
Hamilton, 7 catches, 115 yards. Gained 25 there. First down and 10.
Gus, these guys are so athletic on the outside.
From the 18. Barkley.
Hey, good to see you, everybody.
But they've got a great trigger man, Trace McSorley. Look at the numbers, 18 of 26, 344. 3 touchdowns. That's a record in the Big Ten championship.
We still got 14 minutes to go. And you know he's going to be putting the ball up.
He breaks Connor Cook's record, the former Michigan State quarterback. Second and 10 at the 18. A lot of huffing and puffing going on now for the Badgers on defense. McSorley in the end zone. Barkley, touchdown! The Wizard! And Penn State takes a 34-31 lead.
They have man-to-man coverage. He checks the play to the wheel route. He knows he's got Barkley on TJ Watt. They love that matchup, and even though they can't block the entire blitz, he gets the ball out quick enough. And Trace McSorley with another touchdown pass. That one was a beauty.
Tyler Davis for the extra point.
False start. Offense number 46. 5-yard penalty. Retry.
Davis. Penn State with their first lead of the game. 13:41 to go. McSorley has thrown 8 touchdown passes in the last 2 weeks. The Nittany Lions lead it. The Big Ten Championship on Fox is sponsored by the all-new LG V20. Life's good when you play more. Buy the Dr. Pepper tuition giveaway. Learn more at drpeppertuition.com. Dr. Pepper, it's a college football tradition. And by Cadillac. What a game, folks. What a game. Trace McSorley has been brilliant in this football game tonight. But Wisconsin ready to get the football back. Jamerson. He'll start from the three. And Jamerson gets to the 22 before being ridden down. Let's take a look at the road ahead, sponsored by Coors Light. Whatever your mountain climb on.
Our road ahead is the resumes of these Big Ten teams. These resumes so strong. The Buckeyes, arguably the best resume in the entire country with how weak the SEC turned out to be. Even though Alabama being undefeated, they don't have those top 10 wins that Ohio State can brag about, or Michigan for that matter. And how about these Penn State Nittany Lions looking for another top 10 win? They beat Ohio State, won the East Division, and they're looking for a Big Ten crown.
First down and 10 of the 23 for the Badgers. And a flag. Houston rolling out of the pocket, throws it down to Clement, and he gets out of bounds.
Legal shift, offense, 5-yard penalty, replay first down.
Those type of things don't normally happen to a Paul Christ offense. They're one of the most fundamentally sound offenses in the country. Great attention to detail for this Wisconsin offense, but now they're backed up. And this is the Penn State side of the stadium. Crowd noise a factor here for Bart Houston.
Wisconsin had four games this season with either zero or one penalty. They have two tonight for 10 yards. First down at 15. Clement. Clement! Another slashing run by Corey Clement as Brandon Bell finally brings him down.
Boy, Clement's just had a huge night. The offensive line has done just such a great job of covering up color. Look at that. Even down the field, you've got offensive linemen blocking linebackers. Brandon Bell, number 11, has got a big lineman on him. And Clement can just pick his path all the way down the field and through the secondary.
19 carries, 158 yards, and a touchdown. Second and three. They give it to him again. He picks up the first down and more. Brandon Bell, the safety again, with the tackle.
You're gonna get John Dietzen. He's gonna come around and he's gonna have to block Brandon Bell. They just do a great job of getting those guards around and then bang, covering them up. Then they've got the seam. Clement, great vision, and he lunges forward for the first down.
Gain of six, first and 10 at the 36. Shaw in now. He'll run it in. Shaw. He met Curtis Cawthron and almost had his head taken off.
You know, when Wisconsin's getting downhill and they're pulling guards and tackles, they're much more successful when they're trying this zone scheme where they're just going to everyone move to your left. Penn State's too athletic. That's when they get defensive linemen into the backfield, causing a cut before Clement wants to cut. Or excuse me, Shaw wants to cut and getting him down for a tackle for loss.
Second and 12 of the 34. Ogunmowale in the backfield. Houston in trouble, and Houston is sacked. Cole Farmer, second sack of the day for the Nittany Lions.
Here comes Farmer from his outside linebacker position. Just a totally blown assignment from Wisconsin. 65 Ryan Ramczyk, the left tackle, is an all Big Ten tackle, but just blanked on the protection. Farmer runs right by him, and Penn State forces another punt.
Third down and 16.
Excuse me, third down.
At the 30. Here's Houston. Drops it off. Ogunmowale And Ogunbowale is tackled at the 32 by Kevin Givens. Now the Badgers will have to punt. Look at James Franklin and the enthusiasm on that Nittany Lions sideline.
They're playing with just great energy and pursuit, running to the football, playing physical once they get there. And Franklin loves it.
Anthony Lottie will punt it away inside his own 20. John Reed, the deep man, at his 20. Reed comes up to field it on the move at the 35. And goes out of bounds. 9:52 to play in the fourth quarter. Trace McSorley and the Penn State offense back on the field with decent field position after this. A great tradition at the Big Ten championship game is the performance of our national anthem by the marching bands of both schools. Tonight, Penn State's band director, Gregory Drain, had the honor of directing the Penn State Blue Band and Wisconsin's Badger Band. Our Traditions of the Game is sponsored by Dr. Pepper. It's a college football tradition. First down at the 36 for Penn State. Barkley makes the first man miss, cuts it inside, and glides his way to the 40. T.J. Watt with the tackle.
Tackle by 42, T.J. Watt.
Trace McSorley, 9 straight completions. He's red hot. Second and 6. These receivers for Penn State have been brilliant. McSorley steps up, looks, goes for it all once again. Kosicki in. Out of bounds. Good coverage that time by Leo Musso.
Leo Musso does a great job of forcing Kosicki all the way to the sideline. Nowhere to really throw that, but boy, this passing game has been so good. This has been one of the great secondaries in all of college football.
But if Wisconsin can get off the field here, 3rd and 6 at the 40. Now Mark Allen in the game at running back. Number 8. Here comes a blitz. They pick it up. McSorley in trouble. And throws it out of bounds. Well defended by the Badgers.
Oh, Leon Jacobs hit Trace McSorley late, close to the sideline.
Personal foul. Defense number 32. 15-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
The junior from Santa Clarita, California. You see, he just takes him down late. He kind of drags him to the ground. The flag came out right away, right in front of James Franklin.
He was still on the field, Joel, when he tackled him.
I understand that, but it's the lateness of dragging him down to the ground that draws the flag from the official. I don't know if I agree with it. I'm with you. He's still in the middle of the field, but these officials have been instructed to protect these quarterbacks. And he does so there.
First down. And this is Buckley.
That's certainly close. I mean, that's a huge penalty. I don't know if I would have disagreed if the flag wouldn't have come out either.
Second down and 8. McSorley to the sideline, caught out of bounds. Saeed Blacknell has had a career night. A gain of 10 there.
I mean, these wide receivers have done a great job, but check out where this ball is. I mean, it's just perfectly thrown. Right as he's coming out of his break, very tough to defend as Blackmon goes right up. Ball's right in his chest, right in his face mask. Trace McSorley is playing on a different level right now.
First down at the 32. Barkley cuts it inside. And he'll get inside the 30. What a game for Blacknell. Six catches, 155 yards, and two touchdowns.
This Wisconsin defense has been so good this year. 21 interceptions, first in the nation. Terrific in the red zone. They need to hold him to a field goal here.
Second and eight at the 30. Blackno, the receiver at the bottom of your screen. Deshaun Hamilton in the slot at the bottom. McSorley looking, sets up, goes! And incomplete, but a flag. Deshaun Hamilton had a step.
They were trying to double move.
Pass interference. Defense number 19. 15-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
Hamilton did a great job on that route. He faked Musso as the safety to the outside, and then he took off back inside. And as Musso was his left side of your screen here getting beat, he just reached out and kind of grabbed him, and that's what drew the flag. You see him just grabbing that arm. The actual contact came a little bit earlier, right as Hamilton broke out of that double move.
First down and 10 of the 15. Barkley, and he'll go nowhere. Ryan Conley jumped on his back and took him down. 35 to 31, the winner to win the Big Ten championship and receive a bid to the Rose Bowl and possibly an invitation to the college football playoff.
Well, when they've gotten down here, Gus, it's been all about mismatches. Their biggest mismatch right now is their tight end, Gasecki.
And he's lined up at the tight end spot at the top of your screen. There he is. Andre Robinson checks in at running back. McSorley under pressure. Donovan, and he'll get out of bounds at the 10. Chris Godwin stopped by Sojourn Shelton.
Well, here we go. Huge third down here. Kosicki will come down to the bottom in the slot for a three receiver set.
Third down and four. Kosicki 6'6". And he's being guarded by Dakota Dixon, 5'10". Dixon blitzes. McSorley underneath. Hamilton spinning. And he will not get it. Ryan Conley again with the tackle.
Boy, this would be a tough decision. We saw James Franklin in the first half go for fourth downs twice and fail. And now at fourth and one here, he's going to take the points. Send his kicking unit on the field.
Tyler Davis in to attempt a 24-yarder. And it's good. Penn State 5-14 away with a 38-31 lead.
Let's check out the Nissan Heisman watch as we come right down to it. Votes will be cast on Monday. Lamar Jackson, 51 total touchdowns. Deshaun Watson, tell you, he's come back and had a fabulous season. Baker Mayfield, I think, deserves a trip to New York, and so does his wide receiver, Dede Westbrook, who has just been sensational since coming back from poor health early in the year.
And Jamerson lets this go out of the end zone. Let's check in with Mike Hill in L.A.
Tech. ACC title game. Virginia Tech cut a Clemson 21-point lead at 7 in the fourth. But Deshaun Watson heard you had him on your Heisman list, Joel, and he's not done. Finds Hunter Renfrow. His fifth TD Watson has accounted for in this game. 42-28 Tigers midway through the fourth.
I think Watson has earned a trip to New York. I know he's turned the ball over quite a bit this year, but, boy, you can't argue with what he's been able to do. 34 touchdowns, throwing the football, 3,600 yards.
38-31, Penn State. Wisconsin, do or die now at the 25. 5:14 to go. Play fake. Houston rolling. Houston runs it. And he'll gain a yard. Manny Bowen stops it.
I'm surprised that they've gotten away from that power game with Corey Clement in the middle of the offensive line. That's been so successful for him. Clement on the night, 164 yards rushing. Trying to use him as a decoy. I don't know if that's the best strategy here with Bart Houston on the outside.
Second down and 9. Houston. Over the middle, caught, Peavy. And Peavy picks up the first down as he goes out of bounds.
Good time in the pocket. Offensive line giving Houston a nice clean pocket, and he does a great job of staying patient, going through his reads, and he's actually coming down to his secondary wide receiver, Peavy. Finds him coming across the field and delivers a great accurate ball that allows him to run after the catch.
First down at the 43. After the 16-yard gain. Bradrick Shaw in the backfield. Shaw running left. And nothing. He'll be tackled for a loss. Evan Schwann and Garrett Sickles combining.
Well, I love the motor of Garrett Sickles. This guy plays 100% all the time. Number 90 for Penn State, junior from New Jersey, 6'4", only 260 pounds, so he's a bit undersized, but he makes up for it with effort, and you saw that on the last snap.
Second down and 11 at the 42. Houston finds his man in the slot, Ogunbowale. And he's close to a first down. We told you how dangerous he is catching the ball out of the backfield.
Here's what I love about it is that you're going to get a blitz here and a blitz here, and then Ogunbowale is going to just find the seam, and he gets there and turns right back to his quarterback, and Houston doesn't panic, delivers it up that seam for a great completion, creating a short yardage opportunity here.
Under 3 minutes to go. 38-31, Penn State. Third and one for Wisconsin. They'll hand it off to Ogunbowale. And he's close to the first down.
Brandon Bell got in the backfield. And I thought for a moment he was going to stop him. Made contact in the backfield. Number 11, but Ogunbowale was just able to get sideways enough to fall forward for a first down.
He had to come out of the game limping.
Ruling on the field was that the runner made the line to gain. Play is under further review.
We'll see if he actually did make this conversion. There's 11. Brandon Bell, see the contact in the backfield, and Ogunbowale just falling forward. Have no idea where the ball actually is, unless there's some angle where we would see the ball. I guess they could try, Gus, to piece together a couple of different angles, but even trying to do that from that angle would be very difficult. There the butt hits, have no idea where the ball is. There's nothing that they're going to be able to do in replay. You almost never see a spot adjusted in replay. even that opposite camera, you have no idea where the ball actually is. No way to overturn this one.
After review, the play stance is called. First down.
So a first down for the Badgers at the Penn State 46.
Penn State has started to get more aggressive with their pressures and the blitzing of the linebackers. Wisconsin's answer is going to be the backs out of the backfield catching the ball and the tight ends trying to fill that void at the second level of the defense.
2:24 and counting. Play fake. Houston rolling. Checks it down. Clement, great catch. And he'll pick up a first down and more. What a catch by Corey Clement. Malik Golden finally dropping him. But it's a gain of 13.
When you put a fake right in the face of a defensive end, you're going to make him make a decision. He's either got to honor the fake and take the quarterback, or he's going to try to peel off and take the running back. Houston reads it properly, commit with a great catch, and moves the chains again.
First down and 10 at the 33. Houston rolling, finds Clement again. And he stays on his feet and gets extra yardage. Malik Golden tried to throw him down, but Clement just too strong.
Boy, what balance from Clement on the outside. We see him make the twirling catch on the last play and then fight off Malik Golden.
And you said it, Joel. For Bart Houston, the good plays are checking down to his backs, but you got to feel it, that he's got a big throw down feel in him. Second and six at the 29. They hand it off. Shot. And he doesn't get much. Manny Bowen.
That backside, you've got to cut off the defensive end. And if you're not able to do so, he's always going to squeeze all the way down and make the play. That was 84, A.J. Taylor, a wide receiver, true freshman, 194 pounds, trying to block Manny Bowen, a 220-pound linebacker. That was a mismatch.
A minute and 18 remaining. Ogunbowale back in. Third and six. Houston underneath. But not enough for the first down. Fumagalli about a half yard short. And a timeout called. 104 remaining. 38-31 in the Big Ten Championship.
The Big Ten Championship on Fox is sponsored by Jared, the Galleria of Jewelry. By State Farm, here to help life go right. And by Coca-Cola, taste the feeling.
Take a deep breath. 105 to go. 38-31. Fourth down and one for Wisconsin at the Penn State 24-yard line. Corey Clement in the backfield. Clement. Did he get it? No! He didn't get it. What a stop! One for the ages.
Timeout for a measurement.
Grant Haley, the corner, is the one that came up with the tackle. The same man who ran the
with 1:01 to go. Wisconsin with two timeouts remaining. McSorley hands it off. Barkley. And a timeout called by the Badgers. They have one remaining. 38-31. Seconds remaining. Penn State with the lead, faced with a 2nd and 12. They stay on the ground. Barkley and Wisconsin will use their final timeout.
Charge timeout for Wisconsin. Third and final timeout. So we have 30 second timeout.
All right, our progressive performance of the game goes to the Wizard, Trace McSorley.
He's been unbelievable tonight. 22 of 31 for 384 yards, a Big Ten championship game record, and 4 touchdowns. Also, a Big Ten championship game record. And he hung in there, too, because early in this game, Wisconsin, they were just pounding on Trace McSorley in the pocket, hitting him on almost every single drop back, but he never flinched. He never blinked.
Third down and 11. Remember, at one time, Penn State trailed this game 28-7 with 5:15 remaining in the second quarter. In the second half, they've outscored Wisconsin 24-3. McSorley gives it up to Barkley. He gets outside and stays in bounds. Wisconsin cannot stop the clock with 44 seconds and counting.
And there's only 2 seconds difference between the game clock and the play clock.
James Franklin, in only his 3rd year.
No idea why they're discussing this right now. I think that they're going to start the play clock a little sooner. So it didn't start quite soon enough. That's what they're discussing right now, is the difference.
Please reset the game clock to 43 seconds. The play clock to 40 seconds. It will start on my wine.
Gus, the play here is don't even try to get it off. Receive the snap and sprint towards the back of the end zone to end the game. You've only got 3 seconds, because remember, you don't have to snap the ball until there's 3 seconds left on the game clock. It takes about a second for the ball to get back to the punter or the quarterback or Barkley, and you'd have him run and turn back around and run towards the goalpost. That'll take 2 seconds, and then the game will be over.
Is that something that you practice?
Not often, if at all. But that's the strategy being talked about right now in the Penn State huddle. There's no reason to have a Michigan-esque punt fiasco at the end of the game. And Franklin will likely take a timeout here right now.
James Franklin.
1 minute timeout.
When his team was 2-2, there were rumors floating around that they may have wanted to get rid of him.
And they are on the precipice of winning a 9th straight game, a Big Ten championship, and putting themselves on the doorstep of the college football playoff. There's no reason to even send the punt team out here, and that's what he's talking about. I would put the offense back on the field, make a regular shotgun snap, line up like you do on every single play the whole season, and then have Trace McSorley receive the snap and run out of the back of the end zone.
And with all that has happened with this program regarding the sexual abuse scandal, this is a reckoning, a revival, a regeneration, a milestone in the healing process. Three seconds remaining in the game. Trace McSorley takes the snap, heads back, and that's it. Penn State wins the Big Ten title, 38-31. Welcome back to Camelot. The greatest comeback victory in the history of the Big Ten Championship. James Franklin and the Nittany Lions. 38-31 over Wisconsin. And let's go down to Shannon for the Taste of Winning, sponsored by Coca-Cola.
Another huge play from Grant Haley. Oh my goodness, there were so many emotions in this game, particularly in the second half. But what were the emotions in your defense on that fourth down play?
You know, all year, you know, this team's battled the whole year from the first game to the last game. And, you know, going in the second half, we had no worries. We knew we were going to come out and do what we had to do. Just on defense, we knew they were going to run the ball. That's what they do. The physical offense, they did a great job today. And that last play, everyone just fit their gas hard. It triggered well, and we just stopped them.
You know, all season long, you guys have watched Barkley just do his thing. What do you think about what Trace McSorley did here tonight?
Trace McSorley, he's a winner. I mean, he's been winning since high school. He's a leader of our team. When things don't go well, he's going to be the one to talk in the locker room. You know, he's a vocal leader. You can see it in the field. Everyone respects him, and just things he does, man, it's truly tremendous.
All season long, it's been about focusing on your next opponent. No more left. The committee tomorrow, where do you think you guys should be ranked?
You know, I think we did what we had to do tonight. We got the W, and wherever the committee puts us, you're going to respect it. So, you know, we're just going to go back, watch the film, you know, learn from our mistakes and get better.
Grant Haley with that huge fourth down stop. Congratulations. Big Ten champions.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you. I appreciate that.
Back to you, Gus.
All right. Thank you very much, Shannon. The final score here at Lucas Oil Stadium, Penn State 38, Wisconsin 31. We'll be back with complete post-game coverage, including the Big Ten championship trophy presentation, right after these messages.
What a game, what a comeback for Penn State, the largest comeback in Big Ten championship game history. Penn State, your Big Ten champs for the first time since 2008, knocking off Wisconsin 38-31. Welcome back to the studio here in L.A. Mike Hill with Matt Leinart and Brady Quinn. And fellas, wow, we got the trophy presentation coming up just in just a second, but we knew Penn State was a great second half team, but what about this explosion in the second half, outscoring them 24-3?
I want to say I couldn't believe it, but this is what they've been doing all season long. You're talking about a tale of two halves. Wisconsin defensively completely dominated their offense. They dominated the line of scrimmage. We talked about it at halftime. I don't even know if they made adjustments. They just continue to fight, and it starts with their quarterback. I was so impressed with Trace McSorley, guys. I mean, he was beaten up in the first half. I mean, sacked, hit, but he keeps staying there in the pocket. He just delivers those explosive plays we talked about all day long. They live and die by these plays. The receivers made plays. Saquon Barkley had a good game. I mean, this was an all-around performance, guys. Second half, they averaged 11.5 yards per play. Congratulations to Penn State. What a performance.
Yeah. Here's the thing I love, too, when I see some of those highlights. They got to isolate their wide receivers and their running backs, and they started to get kind of a sense and feel for defensive coordinator Justin Wilcox. He continued to bring pressure. Yeah. Trace McSorley sat tough in the pocket, took all those hits from the first half, and then delivered accurate footballs in the second half and capitalized. He was fantastic.
22 of 31, 384 yards, 4 TDs for the redshirt sophomore. We can talk about the offense for days, but that defense really stepped up, especially on that fourth down play to seal the game.
Yeah, and Brandon Bell led the team in tackles, 13 tackles, 1 sack, 1 pass breakup, 1 forced fumble. I mean, he was all over the field. It was the defensive front, too, getting penetration. You look at him the second half.
Yeah.
They held Wisconsin 1-for-6 on third down. It was the critical situations they were really able to step up. They held only 77 yards rushing, but in particular, 3.3 yards per carry. Wisconsin was averaging 6 yards a carry in the first half, so they really stepped it up front, getting pressure on Bart Houston, making him feel uncomfortable. You can see at the end of the game, they had to roll him out a number of times just to get him away from all of the pressure. So their offense stepped up, but their defense did in a big way,
absolutely,
too.
Absolutely.
All right, we got to stand by. It is time now. Penn State Big Ten chance for the first time since 2008. Time to get you back out to Indy for the trophy presentation. Joel Klatt anchoring our coverage out there in Indy.
Thank you, Mike. Congratulations to the Penn State Nittany Lions, the 2016 Big Ten champions. What an amazing game we just witnessed here. And to help present the championship trophy, the commissioner of the Big Ten, Mr. Jim Delaney.
What a championship effort. Let me present the 2016 Big Ten Championship Trophy to Coach James Franklin. He'll have a few words for you, then he'll introduce a player.
Coach Franklin, what an epic story this story has been of redemption and resurgence back to the top of the mountaintop. What can you say about this group of kids and what they've accomplished here tonight?
Well, first of all, I want to thank the Penn State Nation that has been with us from the beginning to the end. There is nothing like our Penn State fans, alumni, and Letterman. You are the best.
Coach, take us through that last defensive stand. 4th and 1. What did you tell your defense when you were huddled up on the sideline?
Well, Brent Pry, our defensive coordinator, has done an unbelievable job all year long. But it always comes down to our players. And our players believe. They work together, they love each other, they have faith in what we're doing, and when you have that, you're able to do special things.
Coach, in just your third year, you're standing here as a champion. When you're 2-2, did you think this was possible?
Let's stop talking about the 2-2, and let's talk about the last 9 games.
Nine straight victories. Coach, you have a win over Ohio State. You're the East Division champion, the Big Ten champion. You have the 13th data point, as they say. You're playing as well as anybody in the conference, or the country for that matter. Do you deserve inclusion into the college football playoff?
Could you rattle those things off again, please?
9 straight wins. The 13th data point. You're a conference champion, an Eastern Division champion. You beat Ohio State. You just took care of Wisconsin. Do you deserve a spot in the college football playoff?
What I do know is we just won the toughest conference in college football. We've won 9 straight. They say you're allowed to overcome early setbacks.
Coach, congratulations. Well done. We now move towards presenting our MVP for tonight's ball game, the Grange Griffin MVP. And to help present the MVP, one of the trophy's namesakes, two-time Heisman Trophy winner, Archie Griffin. And now, the MVP of the Big Ten football championship game, number 9, your quarterback, Trace McSorley. Congratulations, man.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. We at Penn State just want to say thank you for everything you do. We love you. It's such an honor for me and my teammates to be here right now. We just want to say thank you. Thank our Penn State fans, our Penn State Nittany Nation. We love you guys. Thank you.
Trace, you've had a remarkable season. There's no question about it. You set a Penn State record for touchdown passes tonight. You set a Big Ten championship game record for yards in a game, touchdown passes in a game. Take me through what was going through your mind, in particular in the second quarter when you started finding those receivers deep open for touchdowns.
Just trying to take what the defense was giving me, not force anything. Coach Moore just kept telling me, trust the system and trust the game plan. And our receivers came to me and said, just keep trusting us. They were feeling confident. They were happy in what they were doing. And I just kept trusting them. The offensive line was incredible. Gave us a ton of time. And it just, everything came together in that second quarter, and we were able to carry it on to the rest of the game.
Trace, you guys are playing as well as anybody in the country. Do you and your teammates deserve a spot at that playoff table?
I'm going to let Coach say what he needed to say. I'm going to enjoy this with my teammates, with our fans. It's an incredible moment. I'm going to enjoy this. Coach said what he needed to say. I'll leave it at that.
Trace, congratulations. Well done.
Thank you.
Congratulations to Wisconsin on a well-played game tonight. But mostly, congratulations to all of you, Penn State and Penn State Nation, on a championship, the 2016 Big 12, Big 10 champions. We'll get it back to Mike Hill.
All right, Joel, good stuff. 9 in a row, Big 10 champions. I don't know if it's enough to get into the playoffs, but they certainly made a case
for
themselves.
Their coach is fired up, man.
Oh, yeah, that's awesome. I love what James Franklin had to say. We got so much more to get to the Big Ten championship and get you back out to Indianapolis. Rob, Robert, and Coach Wonstadt with their thoughts coming up right after this.